Dear viewers, welcome to the hometown of Tai Chi, Chenjiagou. So this is our special coverage, the Kung Fu Show China-Africa Friendship. I'm Zhao Zhijing, I'm He Xiaobo. Good afternoon again. So just a few days ago, we are actually in the Shaolin Temple, and right now we move ourselves to the Chenjiagou Village. How do you feel? Actually, I was quite excited because we are coming to the hometown of Tai Chi. You're actually from Henan province. I believe you have visited this place for many times since your childhood. Have you ever learned how to practice Tai Chi? Yes. So 2 days ago, on the 12th and the 13th, we have our live coverage in Shaolin Temple. It is also a place for martial arts. And for Chenjiagou, it's very special. It is the originated place from the Tai Chi. So today, through our live coverage, we will learn how to turn ourselves from freshman to a master in Tai Chi. And also in our live coverage, we have prepared a lot of gifts and prizes. Please stay tuned with us. So make sure you follow Yang Shiping. So just one reminder, please associate your mobile phone number with Yang Shiping. So if you win the prize, then we're able to track you and also send you the prizes. Mr. He, just look what I'm wearing. Well, it's quite beautiful and elegant. It looks like you are one of the masters in doing Tai Chi. When I came here, I actually specially prepared this costume. I just want to be a local person in Chenjiagou. And also, you are holding a fan. Also, I would like to show you the fan. Just take a look. Oh, also, I could see some characters here. Oh, vitality, mental strength. So actually, for Tai Chi, it fits all age groups. And also, it will help to improve your health and have a better spiritual status. And on the other side, you are able to see some of the postures of Tai Chi. So this is the raw material for me to learn how to play Tai Chi. Speaking of this fan, it reminds me of one thing. And actually, a few years later, soon Tai Chi will become a competition item for the sports game. So yesterday, we are in the Chenjiagou Village. We would like to learn more about Tai Chi. So actually, the day before, we were just in the Songshan Shaolin Temple. So right now, we are standing in the city of Jiaozuo City, Wenxian County, and the Chenjiagou Village. So actually, we could see the central area in China is quite vast. A few days ago, when we are in the Shaolin Temple, I was quite impressed by the terrain because we are in the mountain. We could see the mountain and also the forest, and also the Shaolin Temple is located in the middle of the mountain. And also this place is in the plain area. It's quite different from the Shaolin Temple. And also today we are glad to be joined by one special guest. So let's welcome Chen Bing. Actually, he is the 12th generation of the successor of Chen-style Tai Chi. Welcome to join us. When you come here, I can feel your power and your spirit. So maybe later you could tell us more about the Chen-style Tai Chi. It is my first time to come to this place. Actually, this place is very important for the development of Tai Chi. So right now, I would like to show you more sceneries in this place. So Mr. Chen, where is this place? So actually, this is a temple for Tai Chi. Because in the past, we learned this kind of Tai Chi from our family, but now Tai Chi is becoming a treasure for all human beings. Actually, in the end of 2020, we are trying to file the application for intangible cultural heritage. And already, Tai Chi has become one of the items in the UNESCO intangible cultural heritage list. So today, as our theme is the Kung Fu Show China-Africa Friendship. For Tai Chi, I believe right now many people would like to learn about it. Yes, indeed. Right now you could see Tai Chi in all the five continents. So as long as there are people living there and we are able to find some traces of Tai Chi. So I hear that I believe over 400 million people are practicing Tai Chi. Is that the case? Actually, this is the figure published by the International Martial Arts Association. So this is proven. So can you tell us more about this place? So soon we will be entering into the Tai Chi Museum and also the Tai Chi practice area. So now you could see we have three gates here. This is the first one. And if you look closer, we also see some characters on this gate. So in Chinese, it's called a Zhao Shu. And on the other two sides also, you have the couplets. So it conveys a lot of meanings. So we have Zhao Shu, Dong Jing, and Shen Ming. So for these six characters, it also represents the three stages to learn Tai Chi. On the two sides, it also captures some of the essence of the martial arts. When we say Zhao Shu, and for Tai Chi, we have to, first of all, we have to learn how to do the moves. Especially for beginners, if you have no knowledge about Tai Chi, and first of all, you should learn and try to imitate from the masters. So you should master some of the basic skills. And also you have to practice all of these routines and movements. Maybe at the beginning, you're not familiar with all of those moves. So that is the first step. And also we call it the first stage. So you have to improve your movements after you're getting familiar with the movement, and then you would find some inner strength. So this is the beginner stage. So just take a look on the characters engraved on the two sides. We also talk about yin and yang. When we call yin, it means that when we are still our infant, when we are in the body of our mothers, the infants actually they are able to move. But at that time, they don't have any strength, for example, for their muscles, their bones. So it's quite natural for its movement. And after we start to grow up, and we are able to obtain more strength. And then we are able to discharge power. So for this kind of power, which develop at a later stage, this is what we call yang. So for the Tai Chi, we always emphasize the hardness and the softness, and also the unity of the body and the mind. So of course, we have to strike a balance of the body and mind. So also we mentioned about the five yin and the five yang. So on the first stage, you are actually imitating the movements from the masters. But if you look closer, and for some of the trainers and some of the apprentices, they don't know how to react, especially when they are confronting with the enemy. Because you could see for their movements, they are quite rigid and stiff. And there are many weaknesses for the beginners. Actually, for this gate, you could see it's half open. Just like at the ancient gate. So just we are trying to have this kind of design imitating the ancient doors. So meaning that you just open the door a little bit, you have a general understanding of Tai Chi, but you're not able to master the essence of Tai Chi. Actually, I believe for your followers, and he is actually quite familiar with the routine and the movement. So he is giving us a demonstration on some of the movements or actions conducted by beginners. So you have a general understanding of Tai Chi. So now we have gone past the first gate. So actually now I have a question. I believe many people, they start to practice Tai Chi at a very younger age. And then when they get older, they would like to play Tai Chi in gardens and also parks. And some people, they're wearing special costumes. So people may have a kind of concept that maybe Tai Chi is a kind of sports that is suitable for the elderly and not suitable for the children. And indeed, it is a misunderstanding because Tai Chi is not just for the elderly people. If you start to learn Tai Chi earlier, and then you will get more benefits. So after you start to practice Tai Chi, and then you will learn more about the essence of these martial arts. So it's better to get started as early as possible. Because I think for trial, when they're at a younger stage, they're quite soft for their muscles. So maybe it is easier for them to master Tai Chi. Yes, indeed, it is also the same philosophy for a child to practice martial arts at a younger stage. Because they are quite soft in their muscles. And also, they have a level of toughness. But I think for trial, maybe they're not able to understand deep about the essence of the Tai Chi. So maybe it takes some time to understand how to achieve the harmony of their body and mind. So now we are coming to another gate. So in this stage, it is also considered as a middle stage. So first of all, you have to master some basic movement and basic action. So it is not just about the strength. And then you need to understand how you move, how you use your inner power to direct your movement. So we always talk about the unity of body and mind and the harmony of body and mind. So for each one of the movements and each one of the action, so we have to make sure that the waist is the essential part for us to move. So for example, you need to understand when to ward off, when to turn, and when to achieve a central equilibrium. So in this case, we understand how to disperse the force and also how to discharge our strength. So maybe later you could give us more demonstration. Now we have a young master doing the demonstration for us. So once again, in this place, we are also emphasizing the half yin and half yang. So now we are coming to the second stage. Now you could see the gate open a little bit wider as compared to the beginner's stage. So now actually he is playing the sword. So if you are holding the weapon, meaning that you actually lengthen your arms, so meaning that it requires that you need to have more power at your base. So you need to stabilize yourself and make good use of the force at the core area of your body so that you could better manage the weapons. So actually for Tai Chi, some people also use sword and fans and knives, etc. So this is the short sword. And also we have rifles, and also we may have some long poles for Tai Chi. And actually I was quite impressed by his performance, because in my impression, I think this kind of sword may be too heavy. It's very difficult to handle it when you are playing Tai Chi. I have another question. So actually today I'm bringing a fan. So actually I always have a dream to become a master, a female master in martial arts. I also hear a lot of the legends about the Tai Chi fan. We will consider fan as one of the weapon. Well, I think this concept is coming out from our modern life. Because back in the ancient days, if you want to go to the battlefield, it is not realistic you are holding the Tai Chi fan to fight the enemies. Because in some of the film sets or the film scenarios, we may see some people would like to hold the Tai Chi fan. Now we are already coming from gone through like two stages. Now we are coming to the last stage. This is also the final stage, what we call Shen Ming. And literally in English, it means like the concentration of your spirit. It's hard to express with words. Also, I will use one example. Well, when you are doing the same move at the beginning, you will actually just do the movement of your strength. And on the second stage, you actually need to think about it and how to use your inner strength to direct the movement. However, when you come to the last stage, it's more difficult. You have to understand how to use the strength. And also, you need to have qi and also the air inside of your body to direct your movement. So basically, you're guiding all of your movement and the actions with your inner mind. So how many people can come to this stage? So actually I would like to ask the question, like how many people can come to stage? So for example, they're able to achieve the unity of mind and body, and also they're able to make good use of their inner air to direct their movements. So right now we could see many young masters. Maybe we could invite them to show us how they play Tai Chi. So we just talk about for Tai Chi is suitable for all different age groups. Yes, indeed. In this large group, we do have different representatives. We have kids and also we have some elderly people. Actually, in Chenjiagou Village, we always have an old saying. We always saying that if you are coming to Chenjiagou Village, you will become a master of Tai Chi and the martial arts. So right now, you could see they are actually doing the first routine of Tai Chi. So acquire a number of movements. And also, we always mention that for the Tai Chi, it actually is suitable for all age groups. Even though you're not able to walk, sometimes you have this capability to practice Tai Chi. And also, even you're getting very old, you're also able to do the Tai Chi. And in Henan dialect, they always saying that for Tai Chi is suitable for babies, for elderly people, and also for all the adults. Now I could see for the group, they are actually practicing Tai Chi. Yes, indeed, it is suitable for all age groups. So what is the style? And also they are practicing the major frame of Chen-style Tai Chi. And also it demonstrates that they are able to obtain stillness as well as the motion. You mentioned the word a frame. What does that mean? Well, we have the old frame, we have the new frame, also we have the big frame and also the small frame. Can you tell us the difference about the traditional frame and the new frame? So we have two fist position of the old frame, and for the new frame, we also have two different types of the Tai Chi. The reason why we name them as the old one, the old frame and the new frame, is according to the timing of the design of the fist position. So actually the 14th generation of the successor and the 17th of the successor created the new frame and also the old frame of Tai Chi. So right now we are seeing they're coming to the final stage. They're closing the form. And later we will visit the training center. So we would want to know how to turn ourselves from a freshman to a master in Tai Chi. Just a short break. Please stay tuned with us. And then we will be entering into the practice hall. And just a few minutes later, we will start to teach you how to play Tai Chi. Welcome back to our live coverage. So first of all, I would like to salute to the audience. So this is our special coverage of Kung Fu Show China-Africa Friendship. And now we are coming to an indoor practice hall. So actually now you have a very large Tai Chi diagram. It's quite stunning. So for Mr. He, he used to pay a visit here, but this time he felt quite different because we have three person here. So I think for this room is quite big. So how many people are able to practice at the same time in this room? Around 70 to 80 people. But if they just say it's coming here to hear a lecture, this place can accommodate about 100 and 200 people. But when you are practicing Tai Chi, you need to have some space. At least for each one of the person, they need a place about 2 square meters because they need to make a lot of movements and postures. And also for some masters, they will demonstrate different moves. So for Zhijing, she is very new for Tai Chi. So for this hall, how many people will come here to learn Tai Chi? So on the first ground, actually, we are able to accommodate many people. And also we have a basement, which could also be used as a practice room. So altogether, we have a practice room about 500 square meters. And also we have 3 small classrooms for the practice. So right now I can see the Tai Chi diagram. And this kind of diagram is actually everywhere in Chenjiagou Village. I think the atmosphere in Chenjiagou is all focusing on the culture of Tai Chi. And also Tai Chi is part of the day-to-day life for the local people. Because every time when we come to the village, we can hear the conversation focusing about the Tai Chi. So for Zhijing, she is new for Tai Chi. And also, we would like to practice Tai Chi. And we will attend this master class. So I think this time we are able to, we want to learn some of the basic moves. So if we are not able to get a well education, maybe we may get injured. So welcome to our master class. And also we have 2 ladies joining us to practice Tai Chi. So right now you could see they already know how to make a salute. So all right, so let's start our class.
来,学习的,来,我们先,大家转过来面向这边,面向这边这样的,大家先。So
before we start the class, we need to learn some of the basic etiquette. So I will teach you 2 gestures. So we need to, like, for example, pay tribute to our ancestors. So please follow me.
肃正衣冠,升起恭敬心,
so make sure that you tidy up your clothes. And we need to close our palms and also pay tribute to our ancestors.
好,再加一个鞠躬礼,鞠躬。
End of the gesture. And also we need to bow to our ancestors.
好,这样来给大家简单解读一下,就刚才我们的这个合掌礼,包括,你看这两个,
So first, I would like to give you some introduction about these gestures. So when we are practicing Tai Chi, we also want to show our respect. When we start to learn Tai Chi, first of all, we need to show respect. Otherwise, we will be arrogant and not able to learn the essence of the martial arts. And if you're not paying tribute to the ancestors, you're not actually being humble. And this is not good for yourself. If you are too arrogant, then you're not able to do a good job in learning the martial arts. And also, when you are paying the tribute to the ancestors, it just also serves as a reminder to yourself. So now you are starting to learn Tai Chi, you should calm yourself. So now I would like to give you more guidance about how to do this gesture. So especially for people who are in the martial arts sector, so we would like to hold the fist in the other hand. So this is a typical gesture to pay tribute to our peers and pay tribute to the masters. So actually this gesture also has some theoretical background. So now you could see you are using one of your hands to cover the fist. So also means that we should be civilized. We will not use violence when we are doing the martial arts. When we are stretching out our arms, it actually shows the tribute to our peers. So this is the gesture and also the connotation for this gesture. So what is the height when I put my fist? So it should be in front of your chest, and also you should relax your shoulders and then to make this gesture. Do we need to have an angle when we cover the fist? Or just be natural? All right, let's do it again. Salute. All right, now we will start the class. So today I have prepared like three sessions for the class. So I will teach you some of the basic skills. And also the intertwining technique. And also for Tai Chi, we could have like two person practice together. To pushing the hands, the pushing the elbows. And so for all of these gestures, first of all, I would like to give you a demonstration. So for the two sessions, so he will do the demonstration, and then at the same time, I will give you some instructions, and also I will try to correct your gestures. All right. So if you are watching our live coverage, maybe you should try together with us. All right, now the class begins. So first we need to do a starting posture. And first relax yourself and take a few deep breaths. Also use your nose to breathe out. By doing that, you could ensure that you will have a very deep breath. And also make sure that you store the qi and the air in the pubic region. Just feel it. When you are breathing in, you are trying to relax your thighs. So when the air comes to your knees, actually you could bend your knees a little bit. Now it's time to free one of your legs. All right, now you lift one of your legs. And now make sure that the tiptoe touches the ground. So make sure that you have a very natural posture. So stay in this position once again, adjust your breath. After you already take the deep breath, try to feel the air from your whole body. Now slowly move up your arms and lift the arms to the height of the shoulder. Now you should further relax your shoulders and try to separate the thighs and bending the knees. And then you turn the position of your palm. You just feel like you are holding a big tree. So when you're bending the knees, make sure that it is facing your tiptoe. Just try to be natural when you are bending your knees. And also for your fingers, they should face with each other. So, and the distance of the two hands is about 2 centimeters. By doing that, we can achieve opening with closing and closing with opening. So when you are holding your arms, it just feels like just an invisible string holding up your two arms. So right now, actually, there are only 3 points in your body have this kind of lifting strength. So first is for your two fingers, and also the center point of your head. Actually, you are standing straight. So when you are doing this, you have to feel that the acupoint in your head is also discharging force. So by doing that, make sure you suspend the head and also relaxing the neck. So if you could feel the power from the acupoint in the middle of your head, and then you could have a complete relaxation of your body. And make sure that you continue to store the air in the pubic region. Make sure all the strength is descending. All of the power is descending to your feet. So now you may have an experience about the standing. Now we would like to close this form. So when you are breathing out, and then you try to put your hands down slowly. And when you are bending your knees, and then you should raise again. So all of these movements is actually in accordance with the rhythm of your breath. So, and then breathing in and trying to store all the air to your feet. Once again, breathing in, and then you could close your feet. Breathing out again, try to relax yourself, and you come back to the natural position. So just a few minutes, I believe you already have a basic understanding about Tai Chi. So maybe later we can share some of our thoughts. Now I would like to teach you the second gesture. And the second gesture have more movements. Actually, for this routine, when you move, you are following a certain pattern. This is also another important action of Tai Chi. So first, open your two legs, separate the thighs, and also the core, actually the strength is focusing on your right thigh. So just make sure you have a bow stance, and also using your left arms, putting the left arms on your waist. Now we try to move. So move your core to the left part and then turn left. And the left hand is descending, and then you raise the hands and move the core. And so actually you are circling with your right hand. So let's continue to follow this pattern. So just move your hands together with the change of your core strength. So when you are descending, actually the core is on your right. So you need to have a lot of coordination of your four limbs and also your inner strength. I believe at the beginning, it takes some time for you to get used to this action and the movement. At the beginning, you just learn from the master. It feels like your body is not coordinated. So first, we are using the right arm, the right hand, and we relax and descending, and then we use our left arm to do the same move and try to draw a circle in the air. So we are moving right, and then our hands will move left and try to draw a circle. So actually, this is one of the typical moves of Tai Chi. So this is a single hand move. So first, we always practice a single hand or single arm, and later, we will use two arms to do the circling. So at this point, you should raise your right arms. So this is another gesture for Tai Chi. So in this case, for the two arms, they should move at the same time. So when you are moving right, and then you have to twist the palm position of your right arm. So one open, one close, one up, and one down. So this is also a combination of the opposites. So even though these two arms will never touch with each other, but actually they already form a combination, a harmony. So in this case, we are able to achieve the unity of the body and mind. So one hand will do the major move and the other one will serve as a supporting means. So for example, you are moving to the right side, maybe the right arm will do the major move. And at the same time, you have to adjust the breathing together with your movements. So when the right hand is descending, it's time for you to breathe in. So when you try to lift the right hand, and then you could breathe out. So all of these moves actually depend on your breathing. I think all of you are doing a good job. But maybe at this point, you don't have much time to think about your breath. Did they think it is not easy to have this kind of coordination of your four limbs? So breathe in, breathe out again, descending the air to your feet, and then go back to the natural position. I believe you're getting to know more about Tai Chi with some of these practices. It seems very simple, but when you are doing it, it's not that easy. Especially, it's very difficult to coordinate your movements with the breath. So when you are doing it, yes, indeed, it's sometimes very difficult to strike a balance. So we always talk about the unity of mind and body, but it's very difficult to achieve it. That's why we also talk about we need to concentrate our mind, and also we need to concentrate the spirit, and then all of these minds and spirits will guide with our movement. Well, it feels like I have to control a lot of things. My hands, my arms, and also my waist, my thighs, not to mention breath. So that's why we always talk about self-cultivation. We need to improve ourselves, not just at a physical level, but also at a spiritual level. And also we have like another gesture, which we call the palm pushing. So it requires like two people to do the pushing. And under this technique, we have five subcategories. I understand you all beginners, so I will just give you a fast demonstration. So maybe I will just teach you one subcategory among the five types of the pushing palm. So for this gesture, we need two people to complete the move. So first, we will do a demonstration. And later, you could have a try. So first, we need to find a decent distance. So this is an ideal distance. And before we start, first, we need to pay tribute and salute to our peers, so meaning that both of us are ready. lift the right arm, and then you could see the two arms are touching with each other. So I will push, and then he will lean back, and then he will do the pushing again. So this is what we call the offending, and actually he is defending. So in this case, I have to make some adjustments, otherwise I will be defeated because I will lose my balance. So when we are faced with the pushing, first we have to disperse his strength, and then I will have a minor turn. So first I will loosen up my thighs, and also I will try to guide his strength. So first I will guide him to an opposite position, and then it's time for me to attack again. So this is a practice for the pushing, guiding, and dispersing. So it feels like it's quite balanced that for two of us, we are trying to conduct the offense and the defense. However, it is actually a competition of our mind. So for example, first I will guide his strength, and also he will make some adjustment to make sure that he could still maintain the balance. So during this process, two of us will form another circle at the horizontal level. However, for the body, so we have to stand straight. We will not lose our balance. So we should not lean back too much or advance too much. So if you look closer, we could see it is not just our hands and arms are making the circle. Our waist are also making the circle, and also the legs. So this is forming a very perfect twining technique. How do you feel? Maybe we could divide you 4 to 2 groups. So Ms. Liu and Mr. He, maybe they have some basic knowledge, maybe. We will divide ourselves into 2 groups, and then these 2 groups will compete with each other. So we will lower our voice and we'll try to have some discussion to understand how to do the move.
Yeah.
So right now you could see for some of the masters, they're trying to teach the two groups to do the training exercise. So for this group, you could see the master is telling Miss Liu on how to guide the strength of the opponents. And especially they have to pay attention to their turning position and also to be aware of their balance. So actually they should not keep turning and keep drawing circles. They need to follow a certain pattern and also to remain the fluid pattern. All right, it's time for us to compete. So right now we are about to do the twining position. Maybe you could tell us which group is the winner. And also, the winner will also send out gifts to our audience, because our audience are always the winner. So make sure you stay tuned with us, so the first round is about to start. Zhao Ziji versus Liang Zi. So actually, we are not doing a combat. So we just need to have a very friendly competition. So first, put your hands together. Maybe one more time. I think you have to do two circles for one round. So actually, it's getting a little bit intense. All right, first put your hands together. So first, move two rounds of the circle, and in the third round, you are able to use some of your technique. So first, we start to draw the circles. We are only coming to the second round. So we have to hear the instruction from the judge. So again, you have to do two rounds of circling, and then you could start to attack. This is the first round of the circling. The second round. Right, it's time for you to make a fence. So, well, I think Liang Zi has a lot of strength. So maybe Mr. Chen, you can tell us who is the winner. So for the two sides, we could see from your movement, I can tell during the practice, you have your own strengths. For Zhijing, actually, she is quite relaxed, and she's actually doing a very good twining. And for Liang Zi, even though she looks a little bit rigid, but she's able to discharge her strength. So who is the winner? Well, I would say maybe you two will draw a tie, because one represents the hardness and the other one represents the softness. So actually for today's class, we have learned a lot, especially just within 1 hour. We are just beginners, but right now we are able to compete with each other. And now I would like to mention some information about Wang Zi. Actually, Wang Zi used to be a teacher for some African students. Can you share with us some of the stories? So in 2016, I used to be a teacher in Beijing, and also I joined the South South College from Peking University. And I teach students from over dozens of countries. How many students do you have? So for each term, each section, we have about like 30 students. Where do they come from? I couldn't remember all of them. Some of them are coming from Nigeria and Ethiopia. And we would say many African students, they really love Tai Chi. So we will continue to hold these classes. So this is actually a long-term class. I believe this kind of class will be very popular. Thank you very much for your introduction, and also thank you for tutoring. So actually, Liang Zi is the winner, and later in our interview session, Liang Zi will have a lucky draw. And earlier, I asked a question, how many people can achieve a harmony of the mind and body? So actually, I have three options for you. So option A, less than 10, option B, about 100, and option C, about 1,000. So then we will have a second session. So we will make some commentation to see some of the Tai Chi performance from African students. And of course, we will talk about some of the stories between China and Africa, and also we will watch some of the videos provided by the African students. Just stay tuned with us. See you a few minutes later. Welcome back to our show. And just said at the beginning, we would like to have a lucky draw. So I would like to invite Liang Zi. So actually just now the two ladies draw a tie. So we would like to do a lucky draw and we will send out some prizes to our audience. So a lot of people think that only less than 10 people can achieve the state of spiritual illumination. So the answer is option A. So only less than 10 people can achieve the status of the spiritual illumination. So maybe Master Chen, you could help us to pick two lucky audience. I will do the screenshot. So the first one, Xiongmao, and the second, Xiao Xiao, and the third one, Yu Meng. The fifth one, Dongfang Longge, and fifth, Xianren Zhilu. So for these five lucky audience, they're able to receive the prizes from us. Make sure that you also associate your mobile phone number with Yang Shiping. And also we will have a second round of lucky draw. Please make the countdown. I think for some of the audience, they actually participate in our show for many times. Well, actually, we could see we have a lot of fans following our shows. So now we are coming to the appreciation section. So right now we have collected a number of videos from African countries. And among the videos, many of them are playing Tai Chi. And actually, Tai Chi is an important category for the Chinese martial arts. So first, let's take a look on some of the videos. So also, we could share some of the stories between China and African countries. So now, I would like to play the first video. So actually, they are doing the Chen-style Tai Chi. Just look at the move of these contestants. I believe he is doing the 18th form Chen style Tai Chi. So back in the 90s, actually the Sports Bureau retitled some of the names of the Tai Chi. So this is when we have the 18th form Tai Chi. So actually, this is the team from the Sierra Leone. Just look at their costumes. And also, I could hear that they speak very standard Chinese. So for the martial arts fans, they're also the fans for Chinese culture. So they're not just practicing the martial arts. At the same time, they are also deeply attracted by the civilization. So that's why these people always speak very good Mandarin. So actually, last time when we are doing live coverage in the Shaolin Temple, one of our masters said language is very important. If they're not able to understand the language, they're not able to capture the essence of the martial arts. Well, just look at this one. He's actually holding the Tai Chi fans. So just at the beginning of our live coverage, we are also saying that Tai Chi has become an official sports competitive item in 2026 sports game. So now we could see this contestant, he's actually using the Tai Chi fan. And today in the live coverage, also the young lady, the host, is also bringing a fan. So actually for Africans, in terms of their personal strengths, they have a unique advantage to practice Tai Chi. And for Tai Chi Quan, many Chinese people practice it, and also for Africans, actually, they have many life features, unique advantages to practice Tai Chi. For example, we always talk about the hardness and the softness. And for a lot of Africans, they're actually quite soft, and also they have very good muscle conditions. And in terms of the strength, when they are discharging the power and discharge the strength, they're able to do it because they have very good power of explosion. So for Madame Liu, I believe you may have a lot of communication with African countries. Can you tell us more stories about our cooperation with some African countries? For example, use Sierra Leone as an example. Actually, they are very friendly to Chinese people. And for the ambassador from Sierra Leone, he paid visit to Henan province for many times. Because for China, we always help them to build highway and also the expressway. We are also able to build the Fuma high-speed way in Sierra Leone. And for the ambassador, he was quite impressed by the work done by the Chinese government. Because of the contribution of the Chinese technology, they're able to enjoy a better life. And also he's quite impressed by the technology. And also we talk about the Algeria. And this is actually a very large country. And for Henan province, also have a friendly tie with Algeria. And especially during the epidemic, Henan province also showing very big helping hand to Algeria. And also we offer a lot of medical supplies to this place. So actually for Liangzi, she had paid visit to African countries for many times. So can you share with us for the geological location of the countries we mentioned earlier? So first we mentioned Algeria. So actually you could see this place is surrounded by desert and seas. And for the Sierra Leone is also a beautiful country. And later, we may want to talk about Sudan, Zambia, and also the Madagascar. So also, I use the same letter, ABC. I have another country, so you could make a guess where it is. And today we will talk about Niger. So just make a guess. Where is Niger? So this is another question. So please tell us where Niger locates. All right, let's continue our commentation. So Liang Zi, as you visited many African countries, should please share with us some of your stories. Sierra Leone, I think, is a very impressive city. I've stayed in one of the towns for about 5 years. I also consider that is one of my hometown. You know, I live in one of the local residents' house for 5 months. I also check on the diamond industry in Sierra Leone. So it is relatively easier for this country to explore diamond because they are not buried deep down. So when you find the diamond, they will put the diamond in their mouth. Because for diamond is quite tiny. If you drop it on the earth, it's very difficult to identify it. So even though the diamond is a very small piece, but however for the local people, if they're able to sell one of the diamonds, and then it is sufficient for them to feed the whole family. So once they find a diamond, and then they will put it into their mouths to make sure that they will not lose it. And for the Sierra Leone, and they have mountains, forest, and also sea. Even though this country is a small country, but it has abundant resources. And also they have sufficient supplies of fruits. For example, they have bananas, pineapples, very large, big pineapples. And if I put one of the pineapples in my home, and then it smells quite good. So actually, Liang Zi also tried to buy some of the furniture, some weaving chairs in her house. Very interesting story. So if you want to pay a visit to African countries, do not hesitate, because this is a very beautiful land. If you don't have any tour guides, make sure you consider Liang Zi as your personal tour guide. Right now, we will watch the second group of videos. And these contestants are from Sudan and also Niger. Well, I can see for all of these people, they have very good language skills. Very standard Mandarin. Just look at the size of this man. He is very strong. Now we could see he is commencing. And also he is actually practicing the 8th form Tai Chi. So for this kind of Tai Chi form, it's also one of the intangible cultural heritage in China. I believe many African people would like to come to China to learn Tai Chi. Also right now, we also have a lot of support from the government. And also we offer trainings, for example, in the Confucius School. And also we offer the classes on the education of Tai Chi. So for many countries in Africa continent, they would like to learn how to play Tai Chi. So for Mr. Chen, he used to be a tutor and a coach to teach these students. So actually, we could feel like their affection on martial arts and Tai Chi. Well, actually, this person is quite famous. Let's see his performance. Just look at the shape of his body, and he is very strong. Right now in China, how many people practicing Tai Chi? And we know in Chenjiagou Village, there were many martial arts schools. Many people learn martial arts in those college. And also there are many universities open classes to teach martial arts. So in one of the universities in the city of Jiaozuo, they also recruit a lot of overseas students. Half of them are actually coming from African countries. And also these people consider Tai Chi as a compulsory curriculum. So actually for our master, he always pay visit to those universities to teach Tai Chi to the Africans. So it is quite popular sports in Henan province. And also for the local residents, they also welcome Tai Chi. And for some of these Africans, if they play very well, I believe all these people must have some of the travel and some of the training experiences in China. So I would say for these people, they have very good basic skills. Actually, they are quite adorable. They travel a very long distance to China to learn Tai Chi. So Liangzi, what's your impression about Sudan and Niger? I only visited the southern part of the Sudan. They have preserved a lot of traditional culture. I have never visited the north part of the Sudan. I think for the two sides, the culture is a bit different. I think it's very important to preserve the traditions. And if you look at their costumes and some of the totems and even though you consider it as decoration, but that is not the case. For example, they put some like weaving hats on their head, meaning that they're engaged. For people who already get married, they will also put a special decoration on their face. In the past, they may put some bones on their face, but right now they're putting some of the plastics. So if you look at some of the decoration on their body, in their costumes, actually they are conveying the traditions. So it is not just decoration, they are trying to convey some of the culture of local area. So what is the population in Sudan? I'm not sure, because I only visited a part of the place. So now we turn to our topic to Niger. We just asked a question to our audience. So our question is, where is Niger? So just tell us your answer. Where is Niger?
Niger, A, B, C.
Actually, Niger locates in this place. Well, actually, we can see all of these viewers, they get the answers right. We used to export some of the cars or trucks into Niger. Actually, it takes up a large market share in the country of Niger. Also, we talk about Sudan. Because of the war, in 2016, do you know for the peacekeeping force, so actually most of the servicemen, they are coming from Henan province. So actually in 2016, the peacekeeping force, they are actually setting up a service center. A lot of these servicemen, they are coming from Henan province, and for this square, they call it the Henan Square. And actually, Liang Zi used to be a service woman. So when you came to Niger, do you have any conversation of these people? And actually, for our peacekeeping forces, they are staying in Sudan, Congo. I used to stay in Congo as a peacekeeping service woman. Even though it is a long distance from Congo to Niger, but still I was able to pay a visit. So for the peacekeeping forces, they are maintaining the security in the local countries, and also they will build roads. They also play a significant role in these countries. For the local residents, at the beginning, they think maybe the peacekeeping forces, they're trying to make a scene. However, after they hear a lot of Chinese, and some of the local people are able to pick up some of the Chinese language. So also for some of the peacekeeping forces, they speak local dialects, the Chinese dialects. And also for the local people from these countries also learn how to speak this language. And also they even know how to sing Chinese songs. I always have a lot of conversation with those local residents. I believe each time when you're taking a photo, all of these photos are carrying a lot of stories. All right, now is the time for lucky draw. We would like to send out our prizes to the lucky audience. Now the host is trying to unveil some of the lucky audience. Congratulations. Now we are going to see the large group of all the videos. So this video is actually shot from Zambia and also the Madagascar. I think he used to be one of the students from our Master Chen. Very nice move. For all of the videos you could see, for all of these people, these Africans, they're actually wearing these uniforms. And also when they're doing the martial arts, the Tai Chi, they also want to convey the Chinese civilization and culture. I also realized that for the Africans, they have a very good strength. Maybe they have done a good job in expressing the hardness instead of the softness. Actually, for the beginners, this is a natural process. So maybe at the beginning, they don't have a good understanding of Tai Chi. But I believe with practice, they're able to get the essence of Tai Chi. So this gentleman is from Zambia. I think this gentleman is also very strong. I want to understand the method to practice Tai Chi Quan and also the Tai Chi sword. Is it the same? And actually this gentleman from the Madagascar, and he is also very famous, and he can speak very good Chinese. Well, you could see very good style, very nice move and action. How do you feel? It looks like he's very professional. Just at the beginning, he's demonstrating Yongchun. Actually, you could see he tried to combine different forms of the martial arts. Very professional. Now I would like to answer a question from one of our viewers. So she is asking why she didn't receive any prize. Just please be patient, because after we complete all the live coverage, and then we will send out the prizes. So many of you mentioned that many overseas students from African countries, actually, they love martial arts, they love Chinese culture. And today, we would like to have a chat, have an online chat with one of our African friend. And he also has a Chinese name. So Mr. Liu, I would like to ask, how did you get to know Tai Chi? Can you share with us some of your impressions? I'm from Cameroon. Speaking of learning Chinese martial arts, actually, this is one of my class. I also come to Henan University, and with the tutoring of my master in Henan University, I took part in many martial arts competitions. I really love Tai Chi. So first of all, I have to calm my mind. I need to pursue victory by learning martial arts. I get to know better about myself. I have to think about how to do a good job in the movements, in the actions. During my time studying in China, I visited different places in China. I get to know more about China. And in Henan province, I also visited the Shaolin Temple, but I don't have the chance to learn the Shaolin martial arts. If there's any chance in the future, I would like to learn more about the martial arts in the Shaolin Temple. Thank you. Thank you for Mr. Liu, and because she really loved Chinese culture and also she practiced martial arts for many years. It's quite impressive. Liangzi, have you ever visited Zambia and Madagascar? And actually, many people are aware of the big waterfall that locates in between Zambia and Zimbabwe. Actually, this is a must-visit place. Actually, in Africa, people always saying that it feels like it is a country instead of a continent. However, among the 54 countries in the African continent, each of them have their unique features. It takes at least years for you to get to understand each one of the countries in the African continent. Because for different countries, they even speak different language. And also for Tai Chi and martial arts, you also need to take some time to accumulate knowledge. And just as Master Chen said, even though we have a form called a pushing, and under pushing, we also have five subcategories. So it takes us a lot of time to understand all the moves and all the routines. And it is very difficult for the human beings to achieve the status of the spiritual illumination. And for some of the masters, actually, they devoted their whole life to achieve that status. And if we ask all of these masters, I believe all of them would say they are not good enough, even though they are already achieving the spiritual illumination state. And everyone have room for improvement. Because always, we don't have a perfect situation. And also, I think for those who are practicing Tai Chi, they are quite gentle and they are quite calm. So today, we have our two sessions to understand Tai Chi. But please stay tuned with us, and tomorrow we'll bring you more information about Tai Chi. So that comes to the end for today's live coverage. Tomorrow at the 3 p.m., we will present you with more performance of Tai Chi, and also we will have more discussion about Tai Chi, and we will uncover more history about the Chenjiagou Village. Stay tuned with us. See you tomorrow.